Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The biggest disadvantage of being the last speaker is that most of, even if the topic is the same, most that has to be spoken has been said. Nevertheless, I think the only region left untouched is the Indian Ocean, so I shall dwell upon that. So after the end of Cold War, the power is much more well distributed, evenly distributed across the world. The Indian Ocean region gains significance because 40% of the world crude oil and 50% of the world trade passes through Indian Ocean through two choke points, the Strait of Malacca and the Strait of Hormuz. Now, with the emerging economic situation in the Africa, the development and the other Indian Ocean countries, the stability and security of Southeast Asia has gained global significance. Now, with reference to the Pakistan and US relations, we know it has been dampening. So Pakistan has been reaching out to other countries, China and Russia. Now, Russia has traditionally been the major supplier of arms to all the three services of Indian forces. Interestingly, last year, Russia sold three Mi-35 helicopters to Pakistan. The other interesting part is that 3 decades ago, Pakistan was trying to shoot down the same variant in Afghanistan, which they have bought 3 decades later. Why I'm bringing this out is to bring out how the world dynamics have changed over a very short period of time. Now, if you look at China, which has justifiably over the past 20 years become a global economic power. However, the rise of China has driven it to the quest for primacy both in Asia and with the larger interests of gaining supremacy in the world. And now, this has made China to make inroads, as already brought out, in the Southeast Asia region, but it has been doing it through cornering countries in a debt trap. For example, as already brought out, Sri Lanka has already given one of its major ports as part of the $8 billion debt that it owes to China on a 99-year lease to China. Similarly, Pakistan, now we all know of the Belt and Road Initiative, which is going to get further Pakistan into debt of $90 billion to be paid over a period of 30 years. So as a pending debt, Pakistan has already given away its port of Gwadar for 40 years to China. Now, you see around India what is happening, and my fellow panelists has already covered what is happening in Maldives. So we can see forces, Chinese forces, coming to the Indian Ocean. Now, this is not going unnoticed, and USA primarily is very keenly observing all that is happening in the region. Now, China's rise, while it is meteoric, has undermined the international rules-based order. On the other hand, we have India, which works within the framework and respects the sovereignty of other country. That's why we have still not, interfered in what is happening in Maldives. Now, this has made Washington realize that it is Washington needs to reach out to Delhi, so they have delegated us as the major defense partner. They have already, in the last decade or so, supplied a lot of military equipment, which is very important, like the PATI, Maritime Reconnaissance, J-17 and C-130 strategic lift aircraft. They have supplied us with Chinook and Apache helicopter. And they are also promoting Mr. Modi's Make in India initiative by manufacturing M777 howitzers in India. They are also reaching out saying that, we have pre-approved sale of fighters like F-16 and F-18 and the Sea Guardian UAVs, which are technologically way advanced than its peers. I don't know how many of you know that as a gesture of reaching out, last year September was the first time that a tanker with crude oil came all the way halfway across the world from US to India. Washington has also ignored the voting of India against USA's Jerusalem decision in UN. Now, in the long term, USA is seeking to have a strong and powerful military and to have interoperability with India. And USA also wants that India should reach out of the IOR region to the Indo-Pacific region. India, however, is being very cautious and being very careful warming up to USA, and it's taking its own time. Although there are already, two countries wherein avenues of collaboration already exist. For example, there is a maritime exercise that happens between US, India, and Japan every year called the Malabar, the strength and size of which is increasing every year. Now, what USA wants is to include Australia and make a quad. Now, this quad is supposed to be for cooperation outwardly. It's to enhance maritime domain awareness, cybersecurity, and humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. And the benefit of this will be accrued by all the nations of Indian Ocean region. However, the unwritten and unspoken but evident fact is that USA wants to keep a check on the dubious plans of China in this region. The first meeting of Quad in Manila happened in November last year, which is a very positive step. Now, India is the most important country and can play an important role in this region, but India has to be more proactive than reactive. So it has already taken an initiative. Late last year, it has come out with the Asia-Africa Growth Corridor, which is going to link Africa with India and other countries of Southeast Asian region to counter the BRI. And there is also some existing trilateral maritime security cooperation initiatives which were taken a few years ago between India, Sri Lanka, and Maldives, which needs to be revived. We need to include more countries in it, like Seychelles and Mauritius. And India needs to strengthen its relationship within the Southeast Asian countries, except Pakistan, of course, till they mend their ways. And it needs to reach out to other countries of the Southeast Asia and Asia region, whether it is Vietnam, Indonesia, Singapore, Japan, or Korea. I mean, South Korea. So the initiative of liaisoning that India needs to take with Seychelles, it's already started, is a very major step wherein Seychelles and India have had a tie-up, and India is going to have a military presence in one of the Seychelles Island. And we need to take ownership of the Indian Ocean, because there is only one ocean in the world which is named after a nation. Thank you.